Hello Abhipedia users, welcome to Science and Tech Value Addition series with Dr. Vivek Rana. This is the fifth lecture of our series and we have covered space, defense, health, medicine and whatnot. So we will continue with these current affair topics from pre and mains point of view. And today's lecture is once again important from pre point of view more than mains. And the topic, as is visible on your screen, is PSLV C48. So after success of PSLV C47, ISRO has once again launched PSLV C48 mission with success. And more or less, if you have followed PSLV C47 mission, this should be more or less like a revision for you. So once again, the main satellite is RISAT, and I'll be discussing what RISAT is all about, its history, and what is the likely pre-questions which can be asked from it. So first of all, like whenever the news comes, we have to cover this space module from in a systematic form of way, and there is a set pattern which we have designed in our last lecture as well. So I am following it up with the similar headings so that you could be familiar. And if you have listened to the last lecture of the series, then you should have jotted down these points already, and this should be a revision lecture for you. Nevertheless, for new users who are joining just from this lecture, I am highlighting once again. So first of all, you have to start with the launch site from where this mission has been launched, and there are no surprises. It is from Shar once again, Sriharikota high altitude range. And Sriharikota high altitude range is also known as Satish Dhawan Space Center, named after the first chairman of ISRO Space Commission, which was formed in 1972, and it's located in Andhra Pradesh. So after the launch site, we have to highlight what is the launch vehicle. When I say launch vehicle, I am referring to the rocket which is carrying the payloads or the satellites. So we have given the heading PSLV C48, so the carrier is PSLV. So you must revise PSLV and GSLV launch vehicles whenever these missions are in news, because at times examiner might ask where is cryogenic engine associated, what payload it can carry, what is the main objective for which it is designed. So when I say PSLV, it's Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle. It's mainly used for carrying light earth observation satellites in mostly polar orbits. Once we have covered launch site, launch vehicle, the third aspect is number of satellites. Now here it's once again a mission in which multiple satellites have been launched, because as it's economics angle as well, because it's prudent to launch multiple satellites in single mission rather than launching a single satellite again and again from one rocket, because still India has not operationalized usable launch vehicle technology for this particular mission. So it was prudent to launch multiple satellites. And once number of satellites are being highlighted, make sure you differentiate whether all are indigenous or some total it's a commercial mission or it's a hybrid mission having Indian as well as the foreign satellites. So in this mission, 10 satellites have been launched, one is Indian and 9 are foreign. So make sure you differentiate with that heading. Then the main Indian satellite or the payload has to be covered qualitatively. So main Indian payload is RISAT-2BR1. So this is the keyword in this mission for which it is likely to be remembered as well. So this is the main Indian payload. I will discuss what it is all about. So once you have highlighted the main payload, you have to highlight what is the nature of satellite, because satellite could be a communication satellite, it could be a navigation one, or it could be an earth observation, or the we have to call remote sensing satellite. So this falls under the remote sensing satellite or earth observation category. Then for foreign mission, as I have highlighted in PSLV C48 as well, it's always better to draw a table in which you highlight the name of satellite and which nationality it belongs. So in this time, 9 satellites have been launched, but since 6 are from USA alone, so you have to understand the Lemur 1 are the 4 ones which are of USA. Apart from that, one another satellite of US HOPSAT as well as TWAC 0129 is also of USA. So, six satellites of USA. Then QPSR is of Japan and TWAC is of Italy 0092. This is a search and rescue satellite, and the main one which was highlighted in media was DUCIFAT. DUCIFAT is of Israel. So, if an examiner wants to ask a factual question on this topic, he might just mention two or three satellites and may interchange the countries. Broadly, if you are not able to memorize these specific terms, at least memorize Lemur and the DUCIFAT one. That would be more than enough for this mission. Moving ahead, now let's discuss what this RISET-2BR1 is. Now, this acronym RISET stands for Radar Imaging Satellite. So, radar imaging satellite, they are using synthetic aperture radar, which is a quite qualitative technology which helps us in imaging not only in daytime but qualitatively at night time as well. Even during cloudy situations, these RISET satellites come handy. Even though in media you will see that the significance has been highlighted as that it's a radar imaging satellite with resolution of 0.35 meter resolution of images it will capture, and it will help in agriculture, forestry and disaster management. But the real use of these RISET satellites is in defense. You have to understand that RISET was the first RISET was the spy satellite, India's first official spy satellite, which was you set up. And the history is that this RISET 2 is not the second satellite, it is the fourth satellite in the series. Just like if you could recall my last lecture in Cartosat, also I have highlighted that Cartosat was eighth satellite in the series, not the three, that Cartosat 3 term. Similarly, this RISET-2BR1 is not the second or the third, it is the fourth one. The history is that after 26/11 Mumbai attacks, a need was felt that we should have a specific surveillance satellite which could cater to our strategic needs. So, RISET-1 was being planned, but since it was indigenous synthetic aperture radar which had to be used, we couldn't complete timely. So, RISET-2 was first launched, and it had Israeli radar system. Once RISET-2 was launched, then we launched RISET-1, and recently RISET-2B was launched. If you PSLV C-46 mission carried RISET-2B. So, 48 has once again carried the follow-up satellite. It's the fourth one in the series, RISET-2B. And you be prepared, in PSLV C-49 also, it's going to be RISET once again. So, this topic when appears two or three times in a single year, it's likely to be asked in prelim. Because it has happened once IRNSS, when we were developing that navigation system, there were seven satellites which were being launched. In that time, that news had come four, five times. So, UPSC had asked not only prelims question from it, but as well as the mains question from it. So, this radar imaging defense angle has to be seriously prepared as a UPSC aspirant point of view. So, this main highlight or significance is going to be in defense. It will help in checking infiltration as well as counterinsurgency, planning better counterinsurgency operations as well as illegal entry at the border. It just supplements the effort of our military forces. So, this is what RISET-2BR1 is all about. It's the fourth satellite. It's a radar imaging satellite. It's developed indigenously and it has multiple reasons. I'm not elaborating on agriculture, forestry and disaster management because I have covered that theme already exhaustively in our class lectures. So, that will be just repetition of it. But make sure when you are writing in mains, these themes are also highlighted as well, that how it helps in agriculture assessment or assessing forest cover as well as planning disaster management. Now, we come to the main part, that eventually these missions are remembered for some milestones. So, what is the key milestone for which this mission is likely to be remembered in chronology or achievements of ISRO? So, here is the most important point for which it has been highlighted, that it was the 50th mission of PSLV, the workhorse of ISRO. It has stood test of time and time and again delivered the results. So it's an important milestone for PSLV launch vehicle. Moreover, for the site, even the Sriharikota, the high altitude range from which we started this lecture, is also a symbolic milestone. That 75th, it was a 75th mission from there. So make sure you are able to differentiate. It's the 50th mission of PSLV launch vehicle and 75th. Why it's 75th and that 50th? Because this spaceport is not only used for PSLV but also for GSLV launch missions as well. So over the years, over different variants of PSLV have flown from this side. So this is another important milestone, and once again this site is in news. Apart from that, there is another highlight for which it is likely to be remembered, is that the student made satellite, the Duchifet of Israel, it has been launched because it helps in spreading scientific temper, and more students and universities get interested in science affairs, because this is one of the themes in which a country is lacking, and it helps, it inspires youth to take up science as a profession. So there is a larger ambit for which this Duchifet Israel mission is being also highlighted. So this is what we have to cover or memorize from this RISER 2B mission, and that commercial part I have already highlighted, so I am not again emphasizing. This was, since 9 of these satellites were launched under a commercial arm of ISRO, New Space India Limited, which is formed in March 2019, and this was the second successive mission which it has carried out successfully. The earlier one was PSLV C-47. So commercial angle, which is a minor angle of this mission, needs to be highlighted as well. So we have covered all aspects. Now it's time for a practice question, that can you answer this PSLV C-48 mission question I have designed recently. And this question, even though it appears quite straightforward, lot of students made mistake. There is our Telegram group available, State Civil Service Mentorship. You can join it, and these themes, whenever such current affairs are in news, and more specifically state current affairs, I generally upload there at State Civil Service Mentorship Group on Telegram. So this question I had posted a couple of days back, and I received almost 60 plus responses, and only 15% students could answer this straightforward question. That's a little surprising for me. So make sure you read statement carefully and never jump the gun. Like in first statement, almost 50% students have picked the first statement, which says that it has launched the communication satellite RISER 2B R1 in geosynchronous orbit. So satellite name is clear in the A option, but it's wrong. Why it's wrong? Because it's not a communication satellite. You have to understand that remote sensing and communication satellites are two different set of satellites. So saying that it's a communication satellite and that too in geosynchronous orbit of 36,000 kilometers is a blunder statement. So here you have to understand that had I written that it's a remote sensing earth observation or spy satellite launched in a polar orbit, or I have mentioned that it's around 576 kilometers, then A option could have been considered. So A is a big no. In B option, was picked by many students. In this, because it's a clear factual angle which I have highlighted, that mission had sent multiple foreign satellites and 6 were from Israel, which is a wrong. From Israel, there was only one satellite, Duchifet, which was of Israel. 6 were from US. Once again, I'm repeating, Lemur, 4 were Lemur, 1 was Hopsat, and 1 was TWARC 0129. Okay, so coming to the C option one, it's once again in wrong direction. So only option which is there for us to pick is the D option, none of the above. Yes, so make sure you are clear that what this mission is all about. I will bring more questions, because I have seen at times students know what this mission is, what is to be covered, but sometimes they fail to apply themselves. So make sure you never jump the gun, and at times none of the above could also be answer for the questions. If you have any specific doubts regarding this mission, you could just enlist in a comment section, or if you are a student of Abhimanyu, you are always welcome to directly come up to me. I am always ready to help you. I hope this session was useful and you are following up the various other series of Abhipedia as well, which are given in description link. Okay, so keep following. I will be back soon with another Science and Tech Value Edition lecture. Thank you very much.